In genetic genealogy, your grandparents, your aunts and uncles, your nieces and nephews, and your half-siblings all share 25% of your DNA. But just because you guys all share the same amount of DNA doesn't mean that we can't tell you apart just by looking at your chromosomes. Howdy, I'm Andy Lee with Family History Fanatics, and this is a segment of DNA. This is a second in a series of three videos about our close relationships and how our DNA looks different. We're going to be using the GEDmatch.com one-to-one comparison to look at the three 25% relationships that we have in genetic genealogy. The first relationship we're going to be looking at here is a grandparent to a grandchild relationship. Now, what you see when you see this relationship is the recombination that's happened in the mother or the father of that child. And this is where the chromosomes swap different places before being passed on to the children. So the way that we can tell that this is a grandparent relationship is, first off, by looking for great big long chunks of the same DNA. And by the same DNA, I mean the blue lines or the gray lines. Now, each chromosome is going to recombine independently, but most chromosomes are only going to have one or two, maybe three recombinations, and only in rare cases are you going to have four or more recombinations in a single chromosome, and it's mostly going to be in the longer chromosomes. So we're looking at the big segments, and as you can see, in chromosome number one, we have a little segment at the beginning and then a big blue segment, which is almost half the length of the chromosome, followed by another great big gray segment, which is about a third of the chromosome, before we have that final end segment. Now, because of recombination, your end segments might be really short, or they might be moderately in length. But the key characteristic for a grandparent to grandchild relationship is going to be lots of these great big segments on the interiors of your chromosomes. The second thing that we can look for is we can look for chromosomes that are either 100% no match, meaning that they're all gray, or 100% half match, meaning that they are all blue. Now, if you remember with parents and with identical twins, all of their chromosomes were all blue. They were all 100% match across. Well, grandparents can pass on chromosomes to their grandkids if there was no recombination event. And this happens in one or two or three, sometimes as many as 10 or 12 of your chromosomes, depending on your parents and how many recombinations happen. So in grandparents, we can see more of these, and these can be throughout any of the chromosomes. For instance, in this grandparent to grandchild relationship, we see that chromosome 6, chromosome number 9, are both full chromosomes that have been passed on to that child. Also, chromosome number 12 is another one that has been passed on to the child. And there's actually two more down below if we scroll down. So that's a total of five chromosomes that have been passed on completely unchanged from the grandparent to the grandchild. So the next relationship we want to look at is your aunts and uncles or your nieces and nephews. Now, again, these relationships share 25% of their DNA, the same as with grandparents, but how that DNA looks at the chromosome level is going to be different because there's been a different number of recombinations between that aunt-uncle relationship and yourself. So the first thing we want to be looking for is we want to be looking for the number of segments. Now, aunt-uncle relationships should have more segments than a grandparent-grandchild relationship just because there's been more recombination. Now, it's possible that there's some overlap where a grandparent-grandchild has a whole lot of recombinations, and an aunt-uncle doesn't have near as many as a lot of the other aunt-uncle relationships. But for the most part, if there are more segments, it is more likely to be an aunt-uncle as opposed to a grandparent-grandchild. The second thing we want to look for is we want to look for small interior segments. And in particular, we want to look for small segments that are actually close together. So if you remember with grandparent-grandchildren, you could have segments on the end that are short, and that's fine because of recombination, but usually your segments on the interior of your chromosomes are going to be great big long ones. Well, because there's an extra set of recombinations between the aunt and the nephew, there is a possibility for smaller segments, and particularly small segments stacked next to each other. If we look at chromosome number 1, we can actually see this right away. First off, if we ignore the end segment, the blue end segment, it's followed by a short gray segment. And right after that is an even shorter blue segment. So this is an indication that this is an aunt-uncle relationship rather than a grandparent relationship. As we look down through it, we actually see several of these short segments that are much smaller than any of the segments we saw on the grandparent-grandchild relationship. So those two indicators are the first things you're going to look at, is the number of segments and the size of the segments on the interior of the chromosomes. Now the last thing that we're going to look at is we're going to look for any 100% unmatched chromosomes, meaning all gray, and we're going to look for any 100% half-matched chromosomes, which would mean all blue. And that would mean that in those chromosomes, the aunt and the niece or nephew share the same chromosome that they got from their common ancestor. Looking at this set right here, we can see in the first 15 chromosomes that none of them are either unmatched or a full half match. If we scroll down to the rest of it, we see that there's actually two. Chromosome number 16 and chromosome number 20 are 100% no matches. Now the one thing that we're looking for with any of these no match or 100% half match chromosomes is, are they on the longer chromosomes or are they on the shorter chromosomes? Because there's that extra set of recombinations between an aunt, uncle, or the niece, nephew, any 100% unmatched or 100% half-matched chromosomes are usually only going to happen on the shorter chromosomes, and those are the chromosomes with the higher numbers. In this case, there's two of them, and they both are among the shortest chromosomes that we have in our genome. So those three things help to distinguish the aunt-uncle relationship from the grandparent relationship. Finally, the last relationship, that is 25%, are half-siblings. And this one is a little bit trickier, but we have to remember some of the things that we saw with grandparents, with aunts and uncles, and also with siblings. So one of the first things to look at is the number of segments, just like with the aunt uncles. Now, siblings each had a separate recombination event, and so there's going to be many more segments in their chromosomes than there are between a grandparent and a grandchild. Half siblings is the same way. The only difference is since they only share one parent, we're not going to have any of that full match that we saw with this full siblings. But we will see many segments just like we saw with the aunt uncle to the niece nephew relationship. Two key differences here between the aunt uncle relationship with those smaller segments. The first difference is they're probably not going to be the really small segments that we saw in the aunt-uncle relationship. The second thing is we're usually not going to see small segments stacked together. So for instance, if we're looking at chromosome number 1 right here, there is a small segment right in the middle of the chromosome, but on either side of it is a really large segment. And so that's one of the key characteristics that can help you distinguish between half-siblings and aunt-uncle relationships. The last thing to look for is 100% unmatched chromosomes or 100% half-matched chromosomes. In this case, as we're looking, we can see that chromosome number 7 is 100% half-matched chromosome. Now, what makes this significant is that chromosome number 7 is one of the lower numbers, so it's one of the longer chromosomes. So whereas aunt-uncle relationships, we would not expect to have unmatched or 100% half-matched chromosomes in the long chromosomes, with siblings, we would expect them to possibly have those 100% unmatched or 100% half-matched chromosomes. So this is another indicator that it is a half-sibling as opposed to one of the other 25% relationships. Now, I've given you three things to look for when we're looking at the 25% relationships to try to help distinguish them. One key thing to always remember is that at the extremes of these, there's going to be some overlap. So there are some grandparent relationships that look exactly like some aunt-uncle relationships. And likewise, there's some half-sibling relationships that look like aunt-uncle relationships. But the majority of those relationships can be separated out by using those three things to be looking for. Looking for the number of segments, looking for small segments on the interiors of chromosomes, and then also looking for 100% no match and 100% half match chromosomes and where they're located on the genome. If you have any questions about distinguishing between grandparents, aunts, and half siblings, put it in the comments below and we'll try to answer it. And go and try out GEDmatch. See if you can see the differences between your grandparents, your aunts and uncles or nieces and nephews, and your half siblings.
Don't forget to subscribe so that you won't miss another episode of Family History Fanatics. Be sure to check out our website, www.familyhistoryfanatics.com, so that you can find out about upcoming e-conferences that we're going to be a part of.